Hello friends, my name is Vinay and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, let me tell you, I make 3D walkthrough videos which I make from Sketchup, actually from Lumion, which extrude it from Sketchup and make it into a Lumion. I've been getting requests from my subscribers to make tutorial videos because they are very curious to know how I make all these walkthrough videos. So hopefully today I'm going to start a series of tutorial videos. Step by step I will tell you how I make the model and then convert it into a video. So let's get started. Okay, so now we have a plan over here. We are going to make a 3D of this plan. Let's open it. This is the marked portion of the plan which you are going to extrude and make a 3D. For this you have to check your units first. Whatever the units are present in the drawing, you have to use the same units in the SketchUp file. If your units go wrong, then your drawing will totally go wrong and you'll have to scale it back again. I'll tell you in the later videos. But first keep a check of units on both the drawings and make them similar. That's the key. So we have inches over here. Let's just close this drawing. Open your SketchUp. Go to File, Import. Dialog box will open like this and you have to locate your file wherever you have saved it. I have saved it on the desktop, so this is the file. If you don't get your .dwg file, you have to make your file visible from here, from the file types drop down list. You have to select AutoCAD files. Then you will be able to see your file. Select it. Then go to options. Don't forget to check these boxes and switch your units to whatever units you have in your AutoCAD drawing. So I was talking about these units. If your AutoCAD drawing is in meters, then you have to select meters over here. If your drawing is in inches, you have to select inches. So when you're done with all this, just press OK and then open. You get a result box. There's nothing to do, just close it. If you don't see your drawing, you can use this button, zoom extend. You'll be able to see your drawings. And then just pan it over. Yeah, just pan it. Sorry for the technical problem. My mouse is giving a bit problem to me for the first time. Come on. If you're not able to pan with your scroll button, you can use this orbit. Pan and rotate. See, this is the plan and this is the marked portion. Okay, we will delete the unnecessary area. Just select and press delete button or erase. Choose the eraser and just erase it. Selecting is better. If you want to end your command, like if you want eraser, type E. Okay, your cursor will turn into eraser. And you have to close the command if you want to shut the command. You don't want the command anymore. Then you can press space and your cursor is normal, back to normal for selection. Just select the area which you don't want and press delete button. Everything goes delete, 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 delete. Okay, before starting anything, you have to make a group of this of this reference file which you have imported. So select like this or like this, or Control A and right click over it and select make group. Now once you have made the group, you can save your file by pressing Control S. Or go to file, save as, and give it a name like test1, save wherever you want, press save. One tip I'll give you, it is very important, you have to keep saving your file continuously. Like you use one command of move and just press Control S, your file will be saved. Why I'm saying this? Because many a times happens that you keep on going editing on the file and at a certain point it crashes, like it a message comes of bugs flat. I will tell you later what it is, and all your edited version is washed away, you don't get it. So to keep your file safe, you have to continuously press Control S after every command so that you have a latest version of your edited file and you don't have to redo it. That's the key. So now once you have made a group of it, you can start extruding walls. Like first you can start from any corner, this or this. You start from this corner, make a small rectangle, use your push pull command, press P. Okay, rectangle, make a small rectangle. Now to make a rectangle, you can press R, your cursor changes to a rectangle command shortcut, type R and it will start, or select, there's a rectangle, there's a rectangle here, and then make a rectangle, first point and second point, then press P for push pull, or this button for push pull, press this button, the push pull command activates, select the face you want to extrude or push and then drag. You can leave the click, you don't need to drag with the click, you can just move your mouse anywhere and you see. If you want to go down, you can show direction downwards or type minus so that it goes down. Type in minus. Now you need 10 feet height. I'll type 10 feet. You can see here what I'm typing, 10 feet, enter. This is a 10 feet wall. Now, before going any further, just make a group of this wall by clicking 3 times over it. It say 1, 2, 3. And the whole rectangle or rectangular column or whatever it is, wall is selected. And then you can make a group of it by right clicking over it and selecting make group. Now why I'm doing this, I'll tell you later, because when the model is really complex and you want to edit it, it's that time when you need this feature of making groups. So you have one group of your sample plan over which you are making group of walls. Now you can edit your group of wall by double clicking over it or doing a right click and edit group, selecting edit group. Again start with push pull P or the button, select the face. Now if you make a wall over here, till here, will not be able to make this column like this one. So for that, what you have to do is, I'll do Ctrl Z, undo, and again push. Now what you have to press is your Ctrl key. When you press your Ctrl key, a line appears like this. See, now this rectangular column is intact and it will not move. If I press my Ctrl key again, then what will happen is the column will disappear and again there will be a normal push pull come out. But if I press Ctrl again, then it will again come back to the last point where I had selected, and from there I can push it anywhere on either side, this side or this side. So I'll take till here. Now here you have a window, so again I'll push pull with pressing Ctrl so that I have a separate face for window and separate face for wall. So you can continue making your walls like this by pressing Ctrl, separate walls. You can go ahead and make your whole structure like this. See, it's very easy to make walls, but it's tiring. It's fun too. Okay, so you can complete. You can continue making your walls, and you'll end up making walls like these. I'll end my video here, and in the next video, I'll show you how I made this window openings and the floor and also the ceiling. Okay guys, I'll end my video here. I don't want to make it too lengthy for you. If you really like this video, don't forget to give a like to this video. Share it with your friends who are still learning SketchUp, and you can tell me in the comment section what problem you are facing while doing SketchUp. I'll try to give you a solution in my next video. Till then, tata, bye bye, take care.